when Bronson calls him, I don't think between Bronson and Tony they're going to be able to hash out what happened next time. One of our deliverables on the EAM program is a data standards framework, which is going to identify the data standards that are being developed. And what I'd like to do there is going to cross-reference that into the opcodes to figure out, like, almost like a, maybe like a sequencing as well. So when we do that deliverable, which we just kicked it off this week, it should be done by I think it's the end of October, that's when we submit it. So within like 5 or 6 weeks, we should have more clarity on the approach to data standards. Also, the other deliverable that's in flight is the data governance framework, which also submits around about the same time as the other one. So that should also give us a bit more clarity in terms of what the data governance approach might look like. Plus, in that 6 weeks, the EAM program itself will continue progressing. We'll probably have more clarity at the program level as to what the sequence might be, and, which opcodes may go first, or whatever it means, So that thing within 6 weeks, we should have a bit more information, or at least direction, on what this could look like, and potentially how comment could be part of that kind of puzzle. That's synonymous with asset information. That's just the terminology we're using, but just think of it as being asset information. So we have, and I can send this to you, we have an EAM, so an asset information vision, an asset information set of objectives, which have just been, I think I can say, have been approved by the sponsors of the EAM program. So those would be the starting point if you were to do any asset information work in ComEd. They could be a starting point, but no one in ComEd has seen those. And there's no, there's no connection to ComEd. This is just, totally within the bounds of the EAM program. But it would be a starting point for a set of objectives. My sense is I think we should probably, given all the stuff that's going on with the EAM data, the XO level, and the uncertainties related to that. My sense is I think we should probably stay away from asset information related stuff in ComEd. At least in the near term, while this kind of falls into order, that we know a bit more. So if that's the approach we take, are there other areas we can help with? I mean, I hate to leave 100,000 on the table if that's kind of up for grabs. How else can we help them? be talking about this some more. I think they should not do anything massive. I don't think that's going to be valuable. I think this is going to result in confusion and more gentrification for various levels. So, I kind of regret saying it. In some ways, I kind of say that with a heavy heart. I know you've kind of got to the point of agreeing the scope of work and we're about to submit a proposal. But ultimately, we have to do what's right for the client.
Yeah, I agree.
And then in terms of the measure, I mean, asset, I think basically was the one that I was thinking of, because I know that Sashi was just done this for conservation energy. But to your point, if Yagnesh thinks he can do it himself, then it's probably more of a different type of that.
Okay, so what do you say? Bye.